Welcome guys. In this lecture, I will explain SQL commands in Oracle. Okay. Guys, in SQL commands are divided into five types. Okay. SQL commands are divided into five types. Five types. Okay. So the first one is DDL, okay, data definition language. With the help of this particular DDL, data definition language, we are able to create, change or delete table structure, okay. With the help of DDL commands, we are able to create or change, okay, or delete structure of the table. Okay, structure of the table with the help of data definition language, we are able to create, change, delete structure of the table. So here structure of the table means, so let's suppose I want to create one student database. Okay, so we need one student ID, right? Each and every student have one ID, right? We need to have one student name. Okay, next we have fees details, that particular student fees details, right? Along with fees paid by details. Okay, so if you want to maintain student database, you should know these particular things, right? If you want to create this particular structure in database, we should use this data definition language. Okay, so again, this data definition language have different kind of statements, okay, to create table, to change a table, to delete the structure of the table, we are using different kind of statements. So the first statement is create. With the help of this create statement, we are able to create tables. Okay, next we have alter table, alter statement. With the help of this alter statement, we are able to change this particular structure. Okay, it means, let's suppose client requirement is want to change this particular student ID to IDs, just they are asking to add yes, right? So such type of scenarios, we are using this particular alter statement. If you want to change structure of the table, such type of scenarios, we are using this particular alter statement. Okay. Next, we have drop. If you want to totally delete this particular student table, okay, such type of scenarios, we are using drop. Okay. And also, we have rename statement. Okay, so if you want to change total column name, okay, so if you want to change this particular total column name, okay, so such type of scenarios, we are using this rename statement. Okay, with the help of these statements, we are creating structure. If you want to change the structure of the table, if you want to delete structure of the table, okay, such type of scenarios we are using these statements. Okay, so this is the overview of data definition language. Just if you want to create the structure, such type of scenarios we are using data definition language. Okay, next thing is data manipulation language. Okay, DML. Okay, data manipulation language. Okay, with the help of this data manipulation language, we are able to insert data into already structured table. Okay, let's assume this is my already structured table. With the help of data definition language, I am creating this structure, right? If you want to insert the data into this particular table, we are using data manipulation language. Okay, data manipulation language. So data manipulation language is used to insert, okay, or change data, or we can deleting data. Okay, use it to insert, change, or delete data. Okay, so with the help of data manipulation language, we are able to insert the data into structured table, or change the data into structured table, or delete the data into structured table. Okay, so let's take one simple example. So this is my structured table. Okay, I have already created this table structure. I want to insert data into this particular table. So such type of scenarios we are using data manipulation language. Okay, so here in this data manipulation language, we have different kind of statement to insert, change, and delete data. So the first statement is insert statement. Okay, if you want to insert data, let's suppose this is student ID. 101 is student ID, student name, okay, fees, total fees, okay, let's suppose 5000, fees paid by 5000. If you want to insert this type of data into this particular table, we are using this insert statement. Okay, next, update. Okay, update statement used to change the data. Let's suppose if you want to change this particular student ID 101 to 101 to 102, such type of scenarios we are using this particular update statement. Update statement used to change the data. Okay, next we have delete statement. Okay, so if you want to delete data into this particular table, let's suppose I want to delete whole this particular 102 student ID's data. So such type of scenarios we are using this delete statement. Okay, with the help of data definition language, we are creating the structure. With the help of data manipulation language, we are inserting the data into particular tables. Okay, so that is the data definition language and data manipulation language. Okay, next we have DQL or TRL. Both are same. Someone call it as a data query language, someone call it as a data retrieval language. Data query language or call it as a data retrieval language, both are same. Okay, with the help of these particular commands, okay, we are able to retrieve the data from different databases. Okay, so here what we have to, we are creating the structure. Here we are inserting the data. If we want to fetch the data from this particular student database table, such type of scenarios we are using this data query language DQL, or call it as a data retrieval language. So here DQL, okay, data query language used to fetch the data from database. Okay, with the help of data query language, we are able to fetch the records from the database. Here we have only one statement, that is select statement. Okay, if you want to fetch the data from student table, this particular table, such type of scenarios we are using this select statement. Okay, this data query language have only one particular statement, that is select statement only. Okay, next we have data control language DCL. Okay, data control language. So it is used to access database objects. Okay, it is used to control access. Okay, it is used to control access database objects. It means if you restrict the access particular table, this student table, if you want to restrict to access this particular student table, such type of scenarios we are using data control language. Okay, so here only have two statement, one is grant, another one is revoke. Okay, these two statement I will explain after we are discussing all these three statements practically. Then only you are able to understand what is the use of this grant, what is the use of this revoke. Okay, so this particular data control language mainly used for DBA team. Okay, so they are provide some access to developers. Okay, so such type of scenarios database team is used most these particular commands. Okay, next we have transaction control TCL, transactional control language. TCL. So it is used to save, okay, or cancel actions made on table data. Okay, first I will show you. If you want to save this particular student table in our database, such type of scenarios we are using this particular transaction control language TCL commands. Okay, here we have three commands. One is commit, second one is rollback, third one is save point. I will explain these three statements practically, okay, while discussing these three concepts. Okay, while discussing these three concepts, I am explaining these data control language along with transaction control language. Then only you are able to understand what exactly use of these two commands. Okay, so in next lecture, I will explain data definition language create statement. What is the use of this create statement? How to create the table? Okay, so that's it, guys. Okay, thank you.